Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. This integrated strategy signifies that advancements in technology for one platform will be transferable to others, enhancing both operational efficiency and adaptability. General David Alvin emphasized that all these systems would share the same mission systems architecture. He clarified that this would enable the Air Force to modernize an entire ecosystem rather than updating individual platforms, ultimately delivering greater combat capabilities for the American taxpayers' investment. Alvin also pointed out that the Air Force's agreement with Boeing for the F-47 program grants significantly more authority than previous fighter jet initiatives. He stated that the service now has greater control over the underlying technology and that the mission systems are government-owned. This approach represents a departure from earlier programs like the F-35, where Lockheed Martin retained control over intellectual property, which in turn limited the government's flexibility to make changes. Alvin stated that with this newfound autonomy, the Air Force would be more agile and better equipped to incorporate disruptive technologies and develop advanced systems. He also mentioned that government control over mission systems is expected to boost competition among contractors. According to him, this would allow the Air Force to roll out updates at the pace of software development, rather than being constrained by hardware timelines, thus enabling faster and more flexible innovation. These enhancements, Alvin noted, are intended not just for the F-47, but also for integration into the Collaborative Combat Aircraft Program, specifically including Anduril's YFQ-42A and General Atomics' YFQ-44A. He explained to the committee that this comprehensive approach ensures advancements are applied across multiple aircraft platforms, thereby improving overall combat effectiveness. Meanwhile, the F-47 is not designed merely as a replacement for current aircraft. It aims to redefine the future landscape of aerial warfare. Built to outclass and outmaneuver modern threats, it is envisioned as the most advanced, adaptable, and lethal fighter jet ever conceived. Touted as the first manned sixth-generation fighter aircraft, the F-47 is engineered to function in highly complex and dangerous environments. Its development stems from 5 years of experimental X-plane test flights, which were critical in validating its core technologies and design principles. These tests played a pivotal role in refining the F-47's capabilities and preparing it for full-scale production. Officials have underscored the F-47's advanced stage of development, claiming that it surpasses the F-22 in several vital aspects. While the F-22 remains a dominant air superiority platform, the F-47 is expected to represent a generational leap in performance. Compared to its predecessors, the F-47 is anticipated to be more cost-efficient, feature greater operational range, and offer superior stealth and sustainability. Thanks to its modular design, the aircraft can be quickly adapted to counter emerging threats, while also requiring fewer personnel and infrastructure for support. General Alvin also released an infographic on his X account, comparing the Air Force's 4th, 5th, and future 6th generation fighters alongside the upcoming CCA fighter drone systems. Though broad in detail, the infographic provides the first official performance metrics for some of these systems, including a stated combat radius of 1,000 plus nautical miles for Boeing's F-47 Next Generation Air Dominance Fighter. The debate over the necessary range and performance specifications for the F-47 remains active, as the ability to penetrate enemy anti-access area denial zones is viewed as a fundamental requirement. Some experts argue that priority should be given to range and endurance over other features, while others advocate a more balanced approach similar to traditional fighter aircraft. Although a 1,000 plus nautical mile combat radius marks a significant step forward compared to existing fighters, it may not meet all expectations for future air defense scenarios. Nonetheless, the F-47's stated range begins to paint a clearer picture of its capabilities. The figure loosely aligns with the Navy's NGAD effort, known as the FAXX, which was recently projected to offer roughly 25% more range than current naval aircraft. For reference, the F-35C boasts better range than the F/A-18EF Super Hornet, and a 25% increase over the F-35C would suggest a combat radius of around 850 nautical miles for the F/A-20. If the F-47 offers a 50% increase over today's Air Force fighters, it would make sense, given one operates from aircraft carriers while the other benefits from fixed base operations. Still, uncertainty remains over the precise meaning of the plus in the 1,000-plus nautical mile claim. It could imply an increase of 50 or even 250 nautical miles. It's also critical to keep in mind that any public information about the F-47 has likely been curated to avoid divulging too much to foreign intelligence. Nevertheless, these numbers represent the first official specifications made available to the public. The infographic also places the F-47's top speed at over Mach 2, consistent with statements made by President Donald Trump during the announcement and naming of the F-47 contract. However, analysts agree that what truly matters is the aircraft's ability to cruise at supersonic speeds without using afterburners, referred to as supercruise, and how efficiently it can do so. Alvin's Post also confirmed that the F-47 program of record currently plans for 185 units. This aligns with earlier projections by former Air Force Secretary Frank Kendall, who estimated the USAF would purchase about 200 NGAD manned fighters, despite their expected cost being three times that of today's fighter jets. Initially envisioned as a direct replacement for the F-22, the F-47's exact role has become less defined as the timeline for the F-22's retirement has grown more uncertain. Still, the matching figure of 185 aircraft in the infographic suggests that a one-to-one replacement strategy remains a viable possibility. That said, recent comments from senior officials suggest that the final force structure of the F-47 is still under review. The F-47 is listed as having Stealth Double Plus capabilities, an upgrade over the F-22's Stealth Plus and the F-35's baseline stealth. This is not surprising, as the NGAD program always aimed for a highly low observable platform with broadband all-aspect radar stealth and reduced infrared signature. That said, the presence of canards in concept imagery appears to contradict stealth optimization. However, some believe these features may be included as a counterintelligence tactic. The final design could look significantly different, possibly without the canards altogether. Lastly, the USAF infographic suggests the F-47 will achieve initial operational capability sometime between 2025 and 2029. However, this likely refers to the aircraft's first flight and early testing phases rather than full deployment. The same timeline applies to the YQF-42A and YQF-44A CCAs. Turning to the CCAs, the infographic shows that the Air Force plans to procure over 1,000 of these drone aircraft. This figure likely encompasses multiple development increments, with QF-42A and QF-44A making up 100 to 150 units in the initial phase. The second increment, which will probably feature a significantly different design, is now in competition. Even so, the USAF could acquire more units from increment 1, depending on how the program evolves. A notable feature of the CCA is its 700 nautical mile combat radius, a figure that had not been officially stated before. While this is a significant benchmark, it may be considered inadequate by some, particularly in comparison with the F-47's range, since the F-47 will serve as a control platform for CCAs. Aligning their operational ranges is essential. Keeping crewed aircraft on station for extended periods to oversee multiple CCA waves is a possible workaround. It's also worth noting that the 700-mile range probably refers only to the current designs under development. Future iterations of the CCA could differ significantly in range and performance. In terms of speed, both the YQF-42A and YQF-44A are widely considered to be subsonic by design. Anduril's YQF-44A was adapted from Blue Force Technologies' Fury drone, which was once claimed to have limited supersonic capabilities. However, it remains unclear whether such performance enhancements were integrated into the final design. Future CCAs could exhibit varying degrees of kinematic performance depending on mission requirements. Finally, both CCA designs are described as incorporating some degree of low observable technology, especially from forward angles. While they are not fully stealthy platforms, they do strike a balance between survivability, cost, and performance. The stealth characteristics of future CCA models will likely evolve as mission needs change. In summary, these newly released metrics, though limited and generalized, offer the first official glimpse into the performance goals and capabilities of both the F-47 and the first-generation CCAs. While much remains uncertain, the data points to a bold new direction in American air power development. And that wraps up our deep dive into the F-47 fighter. It's clear the battlefield of tomorrow is being shaped today. Thanks for watching. If you found this video fascinating, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and ring the bell. See you in the next video.